In 2025, everywhere you go on social media, you see memes like this.
Stop being homeless.
I can't, I studied computer science.
Stop.
You literally can't escape it. So does that mean that coding's dead? Of course not. AI won't be replacing programmers for a while. I mean, have you ever seen AI make a UI this impressive? Okay, all jokes aside, but if you look beneath the surface of all the mainstream AI tools like ChatGPT, Claude, DeepSeek, all those main ones, there's a ton of small niche tools that are actually quite useful in your everyday workflow. So here are five underrated AI tools that every developer should use in 2025. So for the first AI tool, we have Cody by Sourcegraph. Cody is kind of like ChatGPT, but if it had too many shots of espresso. It's able to refactor your code across multiple files, tell you where functions are used and where variables are called from, and it can instantly jump to any part of your code faster than you can dodge meetings. Who wrote this? Basically, it's like the TA you never had in college that actually helps you through your work instead of judging you. So for the second AI tool, we have continue.dev, and it's a little bit more interesting. It's an open source autocomplete model that actually lives inside of your VS Code, and you can also add your own LLMs like Olama or Llama. It also doesn't send your code to the cloud unless you want it to. So if you write a ton of spaghetti code and you don't want the government or the large AI companies to see it, you'll be perfectly fine. Your bad code is perfectly safe. Speaking of spaghetti code, what if you could actually learn to write code that doesn't look like it was written by a very confused cat with a keyboard? Brilliant helps you get smarter every day with thousands of interactive lessons in math, science, programming, data analysis, and AI. Let's be real. Most of us can spend 30 minutes doom scrolling on TikTok without even blinking. But what if just a few of those minutes actually made you smarter? Brilliant helps you level up in math, programming, and problem solving, one bite-sized lesson at a time. It's like replacing your "why am I still up so late scrolling" with actual real progress. The Brilliant app makes it way too easy to learn wherever you are, whether you're in line for coffee, bored in a class, or going on your phone to avoid social interaction. The lessons are interactive, hands-on, and quick, so you can actually level up in coding or math while pretending to check your email. And if you're like everyone else and keep using AI tools but have no idea what's actually happening under the hood, Brilliant's got you covered. Their How LLMs course breaks down the math and logic behind large language models in a way that actually makes sense. It's perfect if you want to go from just using AI to actually understanding it. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for 30 days, visit brilliant.org/sajarhenry or scan the QR code on screen. Or you can click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. So for the third tool, we have Codium. Codium's kind of like the underrated indie game that your friend told you about, and now that you're playing it, he's saying, "Oh, I knew it before it was cool." It supports over 70 languages, it works in almost any IDE, and the best part is that it's actually fully free. It's not like some apps where it's free until you actually need a certain feature, and then you find out that that's part of the paid version. And it's like super fast, like really fast. You'll type in the word "for" and it's already suggesting your entire semester project, tomorrow's stand-up excuse, and a decent cover letter for your next job. All right, so for the fourth AI tool, we have Tab9. Tab9 is perfect if you care about privacy or if you don't want an AI model judging you just based on the way you code. DeepSeek. It's also trained on fully open source code, so you won't get sued by accident. I hope someone got that reference there. One thing that's also super cool is that they allow you to run it on-prem, which means that you own the server, your rules. It's perfect for banks, corporations, large businesses, or that one friend that somehow found out how to self-host his website, and now he won't stop talking about it. So for the last AI tool, we have a product called Sweep.dev. This one's actually pretty insane. It's literally like magic in the form of an API. You can make a GitHub issue, like, "Oh, this code isn't working," and then boom. It writes the code and sends a pull request faster than you can go to the homeless shelter and back. I actually tried it and it fixed a front-end bug that I've been working on since 2022, and I told my teammates that it was still in the backlog. It's actually such a great tool. It's like hiring an intern that doesn't ask questions, doesn't sleep, and doesn't get paid. All jokes aside, it's actually a super cool product and I'd actually use it in my personal projects. Let me know down below if you want a part two of this, and make sure to subscribe for more coding content. This has been Sajar, and I'll catch you in the next one. I'm heading back to the homeless shelter.